faculty, staff, and of course our adult ed students. My name is Jacqueline Lynch. I am the Dean of Adult Education here at Triton. Welcome to our 45th annual graduation for GED students and completion ceremony for our ESL students. Before I introduce the members of our platform party, I want to recognize our students' loved ones in the audience today. Whether you are a parent, a grandparent, a sibling, a child, a spouse, a partner, a friend, or a loved one, our students are here tonight because of you. Without your love and support, none of this would be possible. Let's give a round of applause for those who are here to support our students. It is now my pleasure to introduce the members of the platform party. Vice President of Academic Affairs, Dr. Susan Campos. Vice President of Student Affairs and Enrollment Management, Dr. Jody Coslow-Martin. Former adult education student and GED graduate, Mr. Juan Silva De Castro. Annabelle Delgado, Enrollment Coordinator. Nadia Kachala, who is one of our ESL students and also works at the front desk. Susan McCartney, GED faculty. Francisco Torres, Completion and Transition Specialist. Thomas Thompson, Completion and Transition Specialist. Nathan Reardon, Director of Adult Ed Faculty and Instruction. There she is. Angeles Guzman, who is the chair of the committee who organized this. And Yvette Paradis, who also works at the front desk. Also with us today are a number of Triton College administrators and staff and faculty. Thank you all for joining us. We're very excited that you're here. Finally, welcome to our faculty and welcome to our staff, interspersed throughout the crowd out there. We thank you for supporting the work of our department. So this evening we are here to celebrate the accomplishments of 112 students. Tonight we have 51 ESL program completers on our program. We have 9 Westlake Scholarship completers. We have 9 Board of Trustee scholarship recipients. We have 29 National Adult Education Honor Society inductees. And we have 14 GED graduates. In our group of ESL completers, we are thrilled to have 18 countries represented and 7 languages. We're especially thrilled to be recognizing 12 students from Ukraine this year. Welcome to the United States. Now it's my privilege and great honor to introduce your keynote speaker, Mr. Juan Silva Castro. Juan is a member of the GED graduating class of 2023. He joined the program at Triton in fall of 2022, and he passed his last exam just last weekend. Talk about cutting it close. He really wanted to graduate. Juan has 2 daughters in their 20s, one of whom recently graduated from law school. He is currently a manager in a logistic and transportation company, and he's interested in pursuing electrical engineering. He plans on applying for the Board of Trustees Adult Ed Scholarship. Please help me to welcome our keynote speaker, Mr. Juan Silva Castro.
Hello, everybody. Thank you. I didn't know it was going to be that many people, but okay. I want to say thank you to the custodial campus staff for providing us this space for our commencement today. Thank you very much. Special thanks to Thomas and Nathan. They've been great through all the process. I don't know where they're at. Oh, right behind. Yeah. Pretty cool, guys. Thank you very much. I would like to thank the faculty for their support during my education. I would like to especially thank Nancy Coquette, Ms. Coquette. She's great. She was my language and arts teacher. The first class I took. She really knows how to motivate students like myself. Nancy constantly encouraged me to take the test, take the next step. She always said, take the test. She's a really nice girl. And make little bits of progress all the time towards achieving my academic goals. My wife, somewhere over there, especially who has given me the most support through food, love, and emotional support. It's so important to have someone in your life who can encourage you to do the right things, who pushes you to keep going. That makes it easier to accomplish your biggest goals. As she mentioned, I have two daughters, at 28 and 25. The older one has a master's degree in law. The younger one is still in school. She's gonna be a registered nurse. So is Hilda, she's a registered nurse. But I'm the only one who doesn't have a goal like them. You know, I haven't get there yet. Now that I'm older, I have the time and the chance to go back and pursue my education. Go to college, well, back to college. The more you know, the more you can do for yourself and help others, which is really important to me. That is why I want to further my education so that I can strive for more opportunities for myself and my family. Sometimes we expect and want things from life that we might not immediately get. But if you don't put the time and effort, you'll never have the chance to chase those opportunities. Using Essential Ed, the app that we have, was very important for me. Whenever I had the free time, instead of going to my phone and browse around, you know, for cat videos, I'll watch a 5-minute video of anything, math, which is the hardest for me. That's why I did it. And that increased my chances of everyday success towards earning my high school diploma. I see myself continuing to go up in the future. When I was young, I made some decisions that were not the best. I had the knowledge, but I was young and I didn't make the best choices. It was tough. Now I go to nice restaurants. Like tonight, I'm going to a nice restaurant after this. I'm really hungry. Go great places in the city, centers of culture. It's a huge change from my beginning. I lived in grinding poverty when I was younger. I lived with my grandmother in the house we had. We didn't even have windows. We had the opening, but there literally was no window. But now it's our chance to better ourselves. My father only finished sixth grade, and my own education was limited. But now I have my high school diploma and the chance to offer advanced education opportunities for my family. I encourage you all not to be afraid of failing. Hello.
He's autistic.
Oh, it's okay. You can stay with me, it's totally fine, yeah. The more the merrier. If he can read, he can do for me. A lot of the students who were in my language class arts with Nancy Coquette were nervous about taking the tests. But I'm here to tell you that you must try taking the tests just to see how you do. And you'll get better every single time. I'm already 48. I know I look 30, but don't be fooled. I know that it's never too late to start a change. If you don't strive toward an education, you may not be able to pursue the opportunities you work towards. Your age, background, Obstacles should never stop you from accomplishing the most important goals to you. I hope my story shines as an example, not for myself, but for all of us here today, who can take the same momentous step each and day and every day to better yourself, to get better opportunities and better hope for the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Juan. You didn't seem a little bit nervous. You did well. You're an example of what our students can accomplish. Thank you again. We now move on to the recognition part of our ceremony. As I said, we're going to recognize 112 students tonight in six different categories. We will present each group in the order in which they appear in your program, so everybody should have a program. The first group of students that we're going to recognize are our ESL completers. At Triton College, we are very proud of the robust English as a Second Language program that we have, which offers a range of class levels from beginner all the way to advanced. This year, 51 students have successfully... Hello? 51 students have successfully completed the program. Let's see. Oh, I can go to the other one. Let me go to the other one. I can do that. So this year, 51 students have successfully completed level 6. Some students completed in the fall and others completed in this spring. So we'll now recognize our ESL completers. We're going to call four groups of names. When you hear your name, please stand and remain standing until all the students in your group have been called. Ladies and gentlemen, please hold your applause until the end of each group. I'd like to invite Annabelle and Nadia right now to the podium.
Blanca Aguilar, Ana Laura Alomía Martínez,
Irena Buchenska,
Marta Chávez de Rodríguez, Nashiwa Angélica Chávez Esper, Mónica Cuevas,
Iván Dari,
Rosa del Río Torres,
Solomía Drabek, Ashraf Al-Hash, Mohamed Abdelhamid Al-Shabasi,
Reina Esquivel González, y Luis Eduardo Flores. Can you guys please turn around so they can see you? Please have a seat. Thank you. Okay, the second group. Angie Jimenez Flores. Jesus Uriel Gonzalez Favela. Luis Alberto Hernandez Bello.
Veronica Karayim.
Jesus David Kelly Galindo. Narumon Katan.
Olena Kovalenko. Anastasia Kovalik. Barbara Kuchevska,
Elizabeth Lopez Bejarano, Karina Julia Noemi Luque,
Oksana Linda, Sukanlaya Manolert.
Can you please turn around? The third group. Viviana Márquez Reyes, Carlos Martínez Valencia, Luis Medina, Nelly Edith Mejia Gutierrez.
Solomia Narednik.
Yanani Nazaros Castillo. Maite Alejandra Ocampo Muñoz.
Mohamed Redha Azir. Natalia Paluch.
Maria Jose Perez Londono.
Sergi Popeluk.
Johnny Posada Mejia. Y Marisol Pozos. Can you please face the audience? The last group, Swache Pocheri Nicholas, Maria Quito, Paulina Yasmin Ramirez Bailon, Elvia Rodriguez, Rosenda Sarmiento,
Oksana Shouhenyuk, Anna Stasishin,
Jake Stevens Lord,
Agata Katarzyna Szkutnik,
Ariana Terriquez, Monica Elizabeth Velasquez,
Sviatoslav Jurenets.
Can you please face the audience?
Thank you, Annabelle and Nadia. One more round of applause for our ESL completers. Okay, so the second group of students that we're recognizing today are a group we call beginner to completer. And these students, when they first started with us, they came and they spoke no English. No understand, no speak English, right? They had no English. And today they are completing level 6. That is quite an achievement. Learning a language does not happen overnight. It takes a long time. It takes hours of classroom instruction plus double that outside practicing. So for our ESL students who have made it from beginner to completer, we want to recognize you by asking you to stand in the same way as you just did, and stay standing until the very end.
Irina Buczyńska.
Rosa del Río Torres. Luis Eduardo Flores. Jesús Uriel González Favela. Luis Alberto Hernández Bello. Elizabeth López Bejarano. Dianini Nazaros Castillo. Elvia Rodríguez.
Oksana Shouhenyuk.
Can you please face the audience? You can have a seat, thank you.
So these students are an inspiration for the students who are currently in ESL 1 and 2, but they have a long way to go. You came when you were tired, you came when it was snowing, you came when it was raining, you came when you didn't want to, you came when your kids were home and didn't want you to leave. So thank you for your commitment, and it has certainly paid off. Okay. Our next group of students are our Westlake Health Foundation Scholarship students. So this group of students are supported by a grant that we get from the Westlake Health Foundation. And the mission of that foundation is to promote the health and welfare of the residents of West Suburban Cook County. And they give funds to a bunch of different things: health, education, direct health care, and a lot more. Well, here at Triton, we're very lucky to have $125,000 per year from the Westlake Health Foundation. And that supports our ESL and GED students who want to pursue a health career. It's only for health career students. This year, we supported 30 ESL and GED students at different stages of their program. So some are starting, some are in the middle, and we have 9 who recently graduated at the college graduation 2 weeks ago, and I think we have one here tonight. So Westlake Scholars, when you think of what you've been through, plus now you're done with the program and you're in a degree program and done with the degree program, you are proof that our students can succeed no matter where you start. You've faced some challenges and struggles, but you've had patience, you've been perseverance, and lots of hard work has brought you this far, and it will sustain you to your next steps. You make us all very proud. I'd like to ask Thomas, Completion and Transition Specialist, to present the Westlake completers. Please stand when your name is called.
Keshawati Adhikari, Olawunmi Ademola Kahinde, Irina Chiz, Abiola Sharon Elisoji, Faranaz Jaldi, Sabrina Masella, Malang Nyasi, Juan Pampa, Valerie Del Carmen Salazar Padilla.
Thank you, Thomas, and congratulations, Health Career graduates. You have worked hard and achieved your goal. Now go out and make a mark on your world. Take good care of your patients. We'll all be patients of someone like you someday. Our lives depend on you. We are very proud of these graduates. One more round of applause. So our fourth group of students that we're here to recognize are the Triton College Board of Trustees scholarship recipients. So the Board of Trustees at Triton College has always been a strong supporter of adult ed, and they understand the challenges that our students face trying to finance a college education. Scholarships help to reduce the financial burden of the rising cost of a college education. This scholarship is very important to our ESL and GED students because it gives them the financial bump they need to take the leap and enroll in a degree or a certificate program. And many of our students wouldn't do this without that financial help, so it gives them a kickstart. Each year, adult ed students who have completed the ESL program or the GED program and are interested in transitioning to the college credit courses can apply for the Board of Trustees scholarship. After an arduous application, interview, and selection process, scholarship recipients are chosen and they receive 4 free college classes to kickstart their career, saving each student about $1,700. This year, 9 ESL and GED students will receive a scholarship, 3 are first-time scholarship recipients, and 6 are receiving the scholarship for a second time. That means that they have completed their first year, they have maintained a GPA of 3 or above, they reapply, and they are receiving it for the second time. So for many students, it can support a lot of the cost, if not half of the cost, of them getting their degree. I'd like to ask Francisco, Completion and Transition Specialist, to the podium to present the Board of Trustees scholarship recipients, and I'd like to invite Vice President Campos and Vice President Coslow Martin to present the certificates to the students. Where's Annabelle? Who's reading this? Oh, you are. Okay.
Jennifer Albizures, Adriana Barajas, Alina Dishina, Flavia Fernandez, Nat- Natalia Kepa. Regina Lucia. Ivan Navarre. Agnieszka Kroroski. And Susana Tiznado.
I think the weather was too nice. A lot of people didn't want to come indoors tonight. So thank you, Francisco. One more round of applause for our Board of Trustees scholars. The fifth group of students we're here to recognize tonight are the National Adult Education Honor Society inductees. So for ESL students, this is very much an American thing, an honor society. There is an honor society for adult education. So we have our own chapter here at Triton College. The National Honor Society for Adult Ed has been in existence since 1991. Its mission is to provide meaningful recognition to deserving adult education students, just like you, to improve student employment opportunities, to develop student ambassadors for local adult ed programs, and to increase awareness of adult ed. The National Honor Society have selected their candidates based on three criteria: attendance, attitude, and work ethic. Over the course of the past few months, adult ed faculty nominated a number of their students for the Honor Society. Today, we have 29 ESL and GED students who met the eligibility criteria. Our National Honor Society inductees will receive three things: a letter of recommendation for employment from the Triton College National Adult Education Chapter, a National Adult Education Membership Certificate, and a National Honor Society membership pin, which you can wear proudly. At this time, I'd like to invite Nathan Reardon, Director of Adult Ed Faculty and Instruction, to the podium to introduce this year's inductees. I'd also like to invite Vice President Campos and Coslo Martin to come forward to present the certificates and pins to our inductees.
Okay, so you can come up one by one, and you can give me your card, and I'll read your name off of it. Blanca Aguilar. John C. Caceres. Solomia Naretnik. Yarmila Marabella. Mm-hmm. Jake Lure Lure. Angie Flores. Daniel Cole. Michelle Davis. Rosenda Sarmiento. Monica Velasquez.
Can we have one more round of applause for our newest members of the National Adult Ed Honor Society? We have about 250 adult ed students over the years who have been inducted into the National Adult Ed Honor Society. So congratulations. Last but not least, the final group of students we're going to recognize tonight are our GED graduates. Going back to school. Going back to school after an extended absence requires serious commitment, focus, and of course, time. It also means having to balance work, family, and life obligations. You're not in high school. School is not your only job. School is one of many things you had to do in your life. Class of 2023, you completed the GED and passed the GED exams this year. No doubt your life was disrupted. No doubt there was added stress. No doubt there was a lot of uncertainty. Despite all these challenges you faced, you persisted and you got the job done. This year, we 14 students who overcame their challenges and passed all parts of the GED test and received their State of Illinois High School Diploma. This used to be known as the High School Equivalency Certificate. Now it is called the Illinois High School, State of Illinois High School Diploma. I hope you'll keep in touch with us in the office, visit us, share your news, and share your hard-won wisdom with the students yet to start here. To present the graduates, I invite our GED math teacher, Susan McCartney, to the podium. I'd like to invite Vice President Campos and Vice President Coslow Martin to present the certificates.
Thank you. Fahila Ali. Carmen Ayala. Juan Caceres. Miranda Marie Gillette. Claudia J. Morales Rios. Edgar Ivan Lopez. Okay, you Eva. Eva Nedoroskova. Eva Nedoroskova. Maricielo Robles. Okay, Katerina Trankinka. Let me say that again. Katerina Trankina. Okay. Sam Joji. Juan Silva Castro.
Congratulations, you guys. You did it, but we're not done yet. Graduates, did you know that the graduation tassel is a symbol of success? Once graduation is over, don't throw it away. Don't put it in a drawer and forget about it and never look at it again. Be proud of your achievement and display it as a reminder of how far you have come. Some people put it in a frame with their graduation picture. Others hang it from the rear view mirror in their car. There you go. Wherever you place your tassel, make sure to look at it often, and it will remind you of your success and give you hope for the future. Before the ceremony, you place the tassel on the right-hand side of your cap. That putting it on the right side means you have earned the right to graduate. Moving the tassel from one side of the cap to the other symbolizes the movement from candidate to graduate, the crossing over into another stage of life. Graduates, please stand. Make sure your tassel is on the right side. You have none? You can fake it. Okay, now turn around and look at those who have supported you through these years. They have helped you on their journey. This is their moment too, because they are bursting with pride. Now please put your hand on your tassel. Now move your tassel from the right to the left. Now, in your loudest voice, I want you to shout really loud, I did it! Ready? Did it. One, two, three, go! You may be seated. Congratulations. One final round of applause for our graduates. As we bring our wonderful event to a close, I'd like to again thank some very important people who have had a direct hand and an indirect hand in your success. I'd like to thank all of your family, your loved ones, those who are here, those who are not, those who have gone before us. They are responsible for you. They have contributed to your success and to your being here today. I share your pride in their joy. I share in their pride and their joy at the prospects that lie ahead of you. At the same time, I share in the gratitude that I know our students feel towards you. No one makes it to this stage alone. Graduates and students, thank you for choosing Triton College, for placing your trust in us, and allowing us to be your education partner. Please know that the door to the Adult Ed office is always open, and we're here to provide support and guidance as you move forward in your journey. Once an Adult Ed student, always an Adult Ed student. You have no idea what goes into organizing an event such as this. Adult Ed staff members, would you please stand wherever you are? Some faces you recognize, some you don't. There's a lot that has to go on behind the scenes to get hundreds and thousands of students registered and through the program every year. These are the faces that have helped you even though you didn't know that they were helping. Thank you all. You may be seated. So much of the department's success really depends on our staff. Their skills, their hard work, their collaboration, and their support of each other, their commitment to our mission to make a difference in our students' lives, one student at a time. I appreciate everything that our staff does, openly and behind the scenes, to keep our department running smoothly. A very special thanks to our graduation committee, who have spent hours, and I mean hours, making sure that every detail of this event was perfect. Great job to our committee. It went off without a hitch, I think. I want to specially recognize the chairman of our committee, Angeles Guzman. Adult Ed instructors, would you please stand? We have quite a few classes in session right now, so many of our teachers could not be here tonight. So, faculty, you have served not only as teachers, but as coaches and mentors. You have taught not only from the book, but also from your heart. You have not only explained and demonstrated, but you have also inspired. You make a difference in ways that you will never, ever know. Thank you. We needed a lot of help, and we got a lot of help from a lot of different departments to make this event happen. To the college staff across the campus who've been working hard behind the scenes to help and help us plan and execute this event, thank you. I think Maria's still up there. Thank you, Maria. Thank you to our horticulture department for our beautiful flowers. Finally, I'd like to thank President Moore, Vice President Campos, Vice President Coslow Martin, our Board of Trustees, and all our college administrators for supporting adult ed. We are lucky here at Triton. We are very lucky here at Triton to have an administration that actively supports the capacity of our students and the strength and the building of our department. They are the ones who allow us to advocate for you, for our department, and for future students. Thank you. So this concludes our 2023 GED graduation and end of year celebration. Guests, could I please ask you to remain seated until the platform party have left? You can meet your students out in the lobby. We have some refreshments in a hallway down to the right outside. ESL students, please go to the gymnasium, and that's where you will get your certificate. Tammy and the teachers will have them, your certificates of completion. And I think that's it. Thank you for coming. Congratulations, class of 2023.